I'm skipping a few things, but I did a lot of different furniture in these times. But also, very often, if I was trying to get materials, I got on the phone with companies, and then they would say, yeah, we have this material, but we have it in black and white and natural. And then I was asked, yeah, but don't you have exciting colors or something, you know, that's more interesting for me? No, we don't have that. So then I thought, you know what, I'm going to make for 1 year only black products, black collections. And the first collection I made was Black Beauties, which was a children's collection made of this recycled plastic. I have to say that the tables that I made, because it was the recycled plastic, is extremely good for outdoor, and it was we still sell that a lot. So it was playing also with the character of the materials. I made a little collection of children's furniture, the Black Beauties. My son was just born, and he was only doing this with his car, like an iron. And I thought, well, I can as well make a car with a handle on it, like an iron. And when I had this finished, people were starting to ask me, oh my God, why did you make this black? You know, it's kids, they should have. But I didn't really think about it. I had been looking for colorful material, but I really also thought, what's so beautiful is that this works very much with looking at objects and fantasizing what you could do with it. And I think kids are masters at that. And it's all about looking. In a way, you could say it's a bit like these wooden chairs. You look at something and you fantasize what you could do with it. Another black project was the Black Gold, and it was dealing with the way industry is set up. If you want to make a whole service set out of ceramic, if you want to, you have to, a soup tureen or some cups or coffee pots or whatever. If you do a whole set, you have lots and lots of molds, and very often that makes it very elaborate and a lot of work. And I thought, well, let's see if we can make as little molds as possible. So, in fact, there is a kind of plunger, a plunger piece, a very thin cube, a tube, a wider tube, and a very wide tube. And with these five elements, you could make, as a kind of ceramic Lego, you can make all kinds of objects that almost start to speak as three-dimensional pictograms for me. And I think by being so black, it also speaks much stronger like that. In a way, you could also say, I play with materials and try to find the appropriate use for it. But you could also say that I'm trying here already to play with industry and make it efficient. I did all kind of projects where materials are coming in and experimenting with it. One of the third black projects was a group of furniture that was called Black Magic. And of course, we can do a lot of laser cutting nowadays, but this was in the early days of laser cutting, and I thought, let's make a laser cutter chair. And by cutting out, what you could say is that this piece here, the seat, fits into these legs. The top part and these two pieces, they make a little block together as well, and they fit between the other legs. So in a way, it's a very efficient, and then you could hook these two leg systems of the sides of the chairs together on a sheet of wood, and it's almost no leftovers when you cut out this chair. I really like that. I don't give a damn if people see that or not, if they are looking at the chair. I think it's important to look at when you are designing. I also made a lot of holes in it, and the nice thing about it is when you make these, the way the holes are made, they are everywhere where they can have it. Not in the most constructional areas, but by using the kind of, I'm sure you do that maybe here as well, you cut these little tablecloths when you fold the paper and you cut out some patterns. It's like that, and the rough cutting of the paper or the holes that are a bit like crooked because of your scissors. You can translate that into the pattern of the laser, and somehow the patterns on this on these chairs, they looked as if they were chiseled out by hand, where you can do 12 of these chairs in the morning, which I liked. It's a kind of game playing with industrial processes and still implementing very almost handmade looking things. This is one of the projects we did really recent. Somehow all these early pieces, they ended up in a collection that we still sell from the studio. And this is a very strange collection because it's not a collection where we add something every half year, but only when I'm in the mood for it, and that could be every 4 years. So it's not a very good marketing plan at all. But this is really about laser cutting tubes. It's a lot of there's a lot of technique. It's not a high tech technique, but you could say in a way this whole system is built up by having one long tube and you cut out some elements and then you fold it together. And it's playing also with the fact that people have some smaller offices at home more nowadays, and how to treat that in more kind of domestic settings. You could put plants or books in your little table, but you can also, if you have a clean desk policy, just slide all your mess in there. What you could say is after a while, there were some companies that thought, maybe this girl has some brains, we could ask her something, and we could ask her to work for us. So slowly I started to work a bit more for commissions and for companies, or this is we did big things, like for a school, we made some elements for on the schoolyard so that kids could sit there, protected and dry. And I started to work for a company called Royal VKB, for which I look at this working for this company as a little bit of doing little inventions. This piece is a garlic crusher, and I have to say that I'm a really bad cook. I cannot cook at all, but I have to do the dishes at home. And when I open my washing machine and I have a garlic crusher in it, which is in Europe usually these squeezers. I don't know what you have here, but do you use garlic at all?
No.
Okay. Well, we use a lot of garlic. And they are squeezers, and it's full of shit after you open your vacuum cleaner. So I thought, let's make something that's easier to clean. So it's a little roller, and there's some ribs on it. You can roll it, you can put the garlic with your hands into the pan, the pot. But by cleaning it under the tap very easily, the metal that is chosen for this material, for this garlic crusher, is a metal that takes away the smell. It's also a metal that's used for when you have, you can use it to take away the smell of fish or lemon or that kind of stuff. So that's what it's made of. So it's quite a practical thing, but also, and it's easy to clean. It's very handy for your kitchen. For them, I also did these bowls, and somehow you could say this maybe suits you more over here, because I know that you eat a lot of noodle soups and blah, blah, blah. But in Holland or in Europe, you could say that also the habits of people change. 50 years ago, people were having dinner at the table with the whole family. They were sitting there and then eating. Nowadays, families are split up because they all have all kind of things to do during the day, and they eat in front of the television, and the father is coming home later. So somehow, I thought these bowls are also a bit to you take it easily to your television and sit in front of the television and eat your noodle soup or whatever. It's also playing a bit with different habits that we have nowadays. And this is another little invention for cracking nuts. It's a pot with a lid that you can use in two ways. By cracking big nuts and smaller nuts, you use the lid which has a top on it in a slightly different way. And the advantage is that all the pieces don't fly all over the place.